Hey guys, Pastor Geoffrey here, and we've been talking the last several weeks about silence, the importance of silence, knowing when to be silent, knowing why to be silent, how to be silent. It all kind of started for me when I looked at Exodus 14, 14. The Bible says, "The Lord will fight for you. You have only to be silent." The idea there being that we don't have to do anything when the Lord is in control. He does the work. He does the fighting. He fights our battles for us. And sometimes we just need to be quiet, be silent, step back and let God do His work. But sometimes we need to know when to break the silence. Sometimes while silence is the best option, there are other times when silence is not the best option. In fact, there are some times when silence is not the right option. Sometimes it's time to break the silence. The book of Esther is a fascinating book with a story about a young girl who knew when to be silent and learned when to speak up. The story begins with King Ahasuerus, a very wealthy and powerful king, and he had decided to show off his wealth by having a big party, and for 180 days, he put all of his riches on display for all to see, for all to visit, and at the end of the 180 days, this king hosted a seven-day festival in the palace garden, and then on the seventh day of the feast, he decided that he wanted to show off his queen. And so he ordered his queen, Queen Vashti, to come and perform in the presence of his guests. But she refused. And after consulting with his wise men, it was decided that Queen Vashti should be removed from her position and replaced with a younger, more compliant queen. And so the search for a new queen began. At the urging of his advisors, the king decided to hold a competition, and the winner of the competition would become the new queen. The most beautiful virgins in the country were gathered and selected, and the king would choose from among them one of them to become his new queen. And so through a series of providential events, a young Jewish girl named Esther was chosen to take the position. It's important to note that the king was not aware that Esther was also Jewish. After some time had passed, the king promoted a man named Haman to a very powerful position in the kingdom. And in response to this promotion, anyone Haman passed by was expected to bow down to him. And all the people did, except for one man, and that man's name was Mordecai. Mordecai, who happened to be related to Esther, refused to deny his God and bow down to this man named Haman. Well, Haman was furious. And when Haman found out that Mordecai refused to bow down to him, and when Haman found out that Mordecai was a Jew, Haman decided it would be a good idea to exterminate all the Jews in the land. He was the second most powerful man in the country, and so he was going to use that power to his selfish advantage. And so he deceived King Ahasuerus, and he passed an edict that all the Jews were to be exterminated. Mordecai, of course, was devastated. He had chosen to follow his God, and the result was the death penalty for his people. So Mordecai arranged for a secret message to be sent to Esther, who was now sitting as the queen. He believed that Esther needed to use her position of power to persuade the king to change his decree, which then would result in saving the Jewish people from certain death. Of course, Esther was terrified. Approaching the king, even though she was queen, without first being summoned, could mean the death penalty. If the king didn't call you into his presence, then he had the option to have you executed. But this was no time to be silent. This was no time to sit back and wait and see what happens. Thousands of lives were at stake, and Mordecai reminded Esther of this in verse 14 of chapter 4 in the book of Esther. He said this, "If you keep silent at this time, relief and deliverance will rise for the Jews from another place. But you and your household will perish. And who knows whether you have not come to the kingdom for such a time as this. If you keep silent at this time, that word, keep silent, is the exact same words used in other parts of Scripture to describe letting go, standing still, allowing God to do what only God can do. When the Israelites stood at the edge of the Red Sea, the Egyptians were closing in, and Moses said, "You have only to be silent, the Lord will fight for you." But now in Esther's case, though the Lord is with her, she has a choice to make. And Mordecai tells her that to keep silent at this time will mean certain death for her and her family. And then he says some of the most famous words in the book of Esther, "And who knows whether you have not come to the kingdom for such a time as this." That's right, Esther. Maybe, just maybe, it was the Lord that put you in this position, that gave you this power, that gave you this favor and access to the king for such a time as this. And we're all reading and hearing this story from different perspectives, from different circumstances, but the truth applies to each one of us. God has placed you right where you are for a very specific reason. It may not feel right. It may not be comfortable. You might be wishing you could be somewhere else doing something else. But is it possible that God has placed you right where you are for such a time as this? Whatever this might be for you, is it possible that this is the time for you to speak up? Now, Esther did go before the king, and the king did listen to Esther, and Esther's bravery resulted in the saving of the Jews in the land, and Haman ultimately was executed for his deceitfulness. Maybe you're watching this and you have a friend who's about to make a terrible financial decision. Maybe your teenage children are making bad choices in who they hang out with. Maybe you see someone taking steps towards personal destruction. I don't know what it is for you. I don't know where you are. I don't know what you're dealing with, but if God has placed you in a position of influence for such a time as this, then maybe it's time for you to break the silence. Speak up. Allow God to guide you and use you right where He has you.